1000 subscribers, but we are taking some time getting there, and I thought I should share at least some things with you guys till then so that we could connect better. So let's begin. I was born on 11 January 1990, so I'm 27 years old, and I was born in Durgapur. That's a city in West Bengal. I don't know how many of you would be knowing that. So I'm a Bengali, so I know Bengali, Hindi and English. Those are the languages that I can speak, write and read. Well, academically speaking, I was a very good student, though I wasn't the nerdy ones, but still my grades were always good. So in my college, I was the topper in my computer science department. Even in 10th and 12th, I had very good grades. In 12th standard, I had scored exceedingly well in two of my favorite subjects, that is maths. I got 98 upon 100, and in computers, I had 97 upon 100. I'm a B.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering, and I graduated in the year 2012. So I have had like 5 years of work ex as a software engineer after it. I'm very glad that I received this question, because there's a misconception among the general masses that it is very easy to earn on YouTube. Let me tell you guys, it is not. And yes, I haven't yet earned anything on YouTube. Till now, I'm only in the investing mode, be it from the DSLR cams, the lenses, microphone, the tripod stand. I'm seeing those as I'm telling. The things that I buy for review, everything is going from my money, which I have earned as a software engineer, not here on YouTube. And let me tell you guys, even if when you're earning on YouTube, for most of us, it won't be sufficient to make it as a primary source of income. Unless you are Superwoman, Lisa Koshy, the Wasabi Productions and all, where they have like million views on each videos. Yes, they are the people who do have sustainable income from YouTube. But how many such people are there? Just count. And for me, it is okay, because I didn't come to YouTube for making money. I came to YouTube to let my creative energy flow. I love editing stuff. Way back when there was no YouTube. No, there was YouTube, but we were not much familiar. Like, we were in the 6th or 7th, and there was Windows Movie Maker. I used to make small films, even with images, not also videos. And as for myself, I was and still am a big fan of YouTube. I go on watching YouTube videos. It makes me feel good. So I thought, okay, so even I have some things that I would want to share with you all. So why not I start my own channel? And that was my inspiration. I already have a good 7-figure salary job, which helps me support my family and also my YouTube expenditures. So money is not on my mind, just letting my creative energy flow, doing something that makes me feel good, that is my target. And guys, don't worry, when I get my first YouTube paycheck, I'll definitely share with you people what is it, how is the conversion rate and everything, but wait till I get my first paycheck. My hobbies are, though it wouldn't be appropriate to tell are because now they are sort of non-existent, still they were like dancing and reading storybooks, and that continued quite well till my college, but after I got into the job, everything's gone. I now perform occasionally, and reading storybooks, that is also like very occasional. So recently I got this book. Actually, I didn't go to a store and buy it. I was at the airport traveling and I had time to kill, and I got two books. I have finished one of them, that is The Spy by Paulo Coelho, that is about Mata Hari. She was not a spy but was mistaken for being one, and that's a tragic story. The things that you were so passionate about before joining the job, you just lose interest. I won't say lose interest, you just don't make time for them. I don't know why that happens, and let me know if it has happened with you too. An interesting question, but I'm a big glutton. You give me anything tasty, I will just gulp it down. So I don't have any specifics, because I like a lot of things, I love a lot of things. So anything tasty, that's my choice. This is a very good question, and I definitely prefer skincare over makeup, because if your base is good, you won't need much makeup. That is what I focus on, and in some of my videos you'll see I'm not wearing makeup. You can see my spot. Makeup means foundation and concealer and those things. Generally I wear lipstick and kajal, but many a times I skip the foundation, concealer, powder and everything, because maybe at that time my skin is breaking. Many believe that at that time you should be putting in more makeup to conceal the imperfections. But I believe you should give your skin time to relax, settle down, and then again start wearing makeup. So skincare over makeup any day. So guys, I have worked very hard and I'm still working hard because keeping with a very good job and also maintaining YouTube is not easy. Still, I do it happily because I can give you guys something. So please subscribe, like, share or comment on my videos. It is a small token of appreciation. I just feel, okay, people are watching my videos. People are loving my videos, are reacting to my videos. This is a way I can see that you guys are loving the things that I am showing you. So I'll be back with another video next week. Till then, bye.